On behalf of Kyoto University and also Research Institute for Humanity and Nature, I'd like to say congratulations on this successful global landscape forum. In this occasion, I would like to introduce our approach of commitment and entitlement for tackle the issue of global landscape and also global warming. Next. our approach is, of course, interdisciplinary among the natural science, social science, and humanity, and do the program in collaboration with local people. Through the commitment to the effort of local people to look for the solution, we explore the transformability of environmentally vulnerable society. We look for the ecological and technological suitable solution while we try to improve the livelihood of local people, of course. But oftenly we find that people face the more serious and the fundamental problems such as land title, or land conflict, or payment in advance system, and so on. Those issues can be called with the issue of entitlement, we think. Next. For the case of peatland legislation that we tackled in last decade, in collaboration with Indonesia government, peatland legislation agency, local university, NGO, and local people, and so on, we implement a program of 3R of peatland restoration, debating, revegetation, revitalization, we implement. But we find that people face the serious issues such as land title and so on, so we add next R, restoration of entitlement. So we say the approach 4R. By combining of tackle with the fundamental issue, we can promote that people will be more seriously involved in the program of restoration. Next. Next. So today I talk about the land title issue. In developing countries, forest tenure conditions tend to be uncontested, overlapping, and insecure. Lack of local control over forest use and management decision is a lasting legacy of state appropriation or state forest. State forest accounts for about a third of forest in Latin America, about two-thirds in Asia, and virtually the entire area in Africa. In the case of Indonesia that we do study and collaboration with local people, 70% of Indonesian territory is the state forest, Kawasan Hutan, and 40 million people live on and around the area without their own property right on land or insecure land right. Next. This is a picture of Indonesian land title. People who have the property right, like Japanese or people in advanced countries, is only this part. People here have customary land title. But in the process of development, such as land acquisition, land title in this land title of these people are old, usually neglected. They are not paid compensation. And here also large area of state land and state forest, because those vast state forest government can give the concession to the company, but here also there are many people, so automatically there is a overlapping of land title and conflict and so on. So we look for the solution to stressing the land title of local people or minority or stressing customary land title and so on. So this next Next. Government is next. Government aware of those issues. Government present government promote the agrarian reform. And people here are given the land title. People here are given land title by the way changing the boundary of state forest. And people here are given the land title of land use by the program of social forestry program. Next. So we implement the social forestry program in the research area in collaboration with company local people here. People here on the land of state forest and company concession and land dispute. So with introducing the social forestry program, those issues, those conflicts are settled and people are involved in the peatland restoration program. That is our idea. So. This is my introduction. Thank you very much.